Title, Oopsie Daisy. Shane's transparency tour crashes and burns on social media. TLDR. Shine, the fast fashion Goliath, tried to revamp its image with an influencer tour to a factory in China, hoping for a sparkly PR moment. Instead, things went hilariously off the rails when influencers came back with suspiciously glowing reviews. The move was widely mocked, reigniting debates about fast fashion, influencers, and the power of PR stunts. Now, onto our story. When Shine decided to invite influencers to one of its factories in China, it probably seemed like a savvy PR move. It's like saying, hey, we've got nothing to hide here. Come, see our labor practices and tell the world we're all good. Right? Well, let's just say the reality was not as Instagram-friendly as they might have hoped. Instead of a PR victory lap, Shine found itself on the sharp end of the internet's collective sense of irony. I expected the facility to be so filled with people just slaving away, but I was actually pleasantly surprised that most of these things were robotic, said influencer Destine, followed by Danny's comment, there is a narrative fed to us in the US about Shine, urging people to be independent thinkers. Something seems fishy here, doesn't it? But as we all know, the internet can be as ruthless as it is entertaining. Followers were quick to question the authenticity of these oh-so-perfect factory conditions. One even suggested that if Shine really wanted to be transparent, it would have invited investigative journalists instead of influencers. Well, we can't argue with that logic, can we? Ella, a TikToker posting about sustainable fashion, gave us the perfect satirical cherry on top by making a mock video pretending to tour the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory, a historical site of a deadly industrial fire. Now that's what we call snarky. As if this weren't enough, there's more drama in the mix. CBC investigation found that some Shine items contain significant amounts of lead, almost 20 times the safe limit for kids. Wowza, could things get any worse for Shine? Amidst the outcry, influencer Danny DMC confessed she hadn't done enough background research before going to China with Shine. An eye-opener indeed, but at least it pushed her to reconsider her affiliations and fight harder for sustainable options. Go, Danny. Shine, in its defense, stated that the influencer trip reflected its commitment to transparency and authenticity. But with such backlash, the burning question, pun totally intended, is, can Shine and the influencers associated with it recover their credibility? Or has this PR fiasco permanently singed their reputations? But what do you think? Was Shane's influencer trip a PR disaster or a well-intentioned transparency exercise gone wrong? And how much can we trust influencers when it comes to topics like labor conditions and environmental sustainability? Drop your thoughts below and let's get this debate going.